So this video, I'm going to share my thoughts on the TV show 24, and particularly Season 3. Season 3 was quite interesting. I was initially surprised by the fact that Kim is working in CTU. How the hell did that happen? She's like, what, 16? And she works in the CTU as like a data analyst or something? It just goes, you know, that just made me go bonkers. And she's really annoying as well in Season 3. Really, really annoying. You know, I get the reason that they added in for plot device. It kind of makes it interesting. But now that Kim is just there in CTU, she doesn't have her own separate story, which is also kind of a good thing. Because if she had a separate story like she did in Season 2, it just was not, you know, because they have to keep the suspense going for, you know, 24 hours. They had to think of really ridiculous scenarios for Kim's story. And they were really ridiculous and too over the top and too implausible. So that much is good. But just Kim being there in CTU, just, I don't really buy it. And she's really not that good because she creates problems, like just personal problems, you know. Her feelings for Chase, her feelings for Dad, and Jack's feelings for her. So, you know, there's always these problems, you know. She doesn't want Jack to go there. Jack doesn't want her to go there. And it's just annoying, you know. If that's to provide suspense or tension, the show didn't really achieve that. It just really provided annoyance. Another thing is, finally, it's 3 years after the events of Season 2. It's a long time, you know, and it's really great to see President Palmer again, but the Season 3 is the first time where President Palmer actually starts doing dirty work, and it has drastic consequences. The most devastating consequence, the consequences are so devastating, in fact, that President Palmer eventually says that he will not run for presidency for the next term. So he's been devastated by it too, you know, death of Michelle Palmer. This is the season that she dies. Oh man, that was, I don't know, the way she dies is just so crazy, but the way the political situation escalates from him having to deal with the political scandal of his girlfriend to now his big financial backer having found out that his brother has been cheating on his wife and da-da-da, and David Palmer is pretty adamant that he will not give in to threats. And so, instead of giving in to threats, he actually uses Michelle Palmer to do blackmailing and all that, which is, you know, which is not a very smart thing. You know, by going into this dirty business, David Palmer essentially made things a lot worse, you know. And I think that's the first time we see David Palmer making really hard decisions that he should not have made, and we see the consequences of that. I was really particularly struck by the reality of the virus, you know, that gets released, and it's a crazy situation. They have one leak, you know, that one guy leaves the hotel, and that one guy meets his wife, meets some people at the supermarket, liquor store, and he meets the people at the hospital, and that line of exposure, you know, now every the CTO agents are going, he met these people, find about how to contain the exposure, to kind of quarantine them, and the process quarantine, you know, that just boggles my mind how that must be. But the process of Jack getting to all those different viruses was really interesting. Really cool. Him having to face off against the agent that was supposed to have been killed in the Kosovo operation. That was really cool. That character is pretty badass. And the only leverage that he had was his daughter. And that was found out by Ryan, you know, Ryan's computer skills, the money trailing stuff. The fact that Jack had to make really tough decisions in the season. You know, killing Ryan, that was tough, you know, and the stuff that happens in Season 3 is pretty shocking, you know. I think plot wise, there's a lot of intense moments in season three that makes it really great. Him having to go undercover and chase, not knowing about Jack, goes dark, and now I mean, there's so much stuff that happens in season three. I think there's finally closure with Nina Myers, and Chase's arm, Chase's hands gets chopped off because of the virus at the very, very end. There's a lot of really interesting stuff, and Tony also. Oh, that's the one last thing I want to end with the video. The last thing about Tony. It's pretty much the same situation as Jack was in season one. His wife and daughter were kidnapped. And Tony, his wife, Michelle, has been kidnapped. But Jack kind of thought things through in the first season, Even though he was complying with terrorists, he was always thinking of new ways to take the terrorists down. Whereas Tony just complied with the terrorists, and he would have just complied anyway. And I think that's what kind of differentiates it. But even so, the fact that he gets, the ending for Tony in season three is just not cool. I mean, Tony did so much for CTU and for national security, and just for that one mistake, he gets sent to prison for treason. And it's only beginning of season four that we begin to understand what happened. But still, it's kind of devastating, to see that happen to Tony. There is really no appreciation at all for CTU field agents by the CTU division and by the higher ups. They're all expendable. So the way they put their lives on the line for the country is pretty remarkable. Also, another funny thing that I want to end with on this video, a funny note that I want to end on, is that in 24, whenever they show news clips, it's always Fox News. And that's just funny to me, because 24 is a show that airs on Fox, the Fox channel. The news that you see on 24 is Fox News. So I found that pretty funny. But yeah, I wanted to know.